Alright, oh my gosh. Well, I guess in talk speak, nothing is affordable anymore. I was looking at, you know, I was trying to gain some kind of happiness out of the South, you know, going to Alabama or South Carolina, Louisiana, Kentucky, Tennessee. I was trying to glean some kind of happiness in those prices for a moment, and there they are there, and I'm thinking, well, if that's the answer for the tech workers, people who live and work online, who don't have a brick and mortar, if that's the answer is for them to all move to the South, well, then the South will be rightly recompensated with a price rise, won't it? So it will have a property increase. So how to stop that? You know, in the desperation to leave, you know, this particular horrible situation of the prices don't fall, and you know, even if they did, it wouldn't be enough. So in leaving this situation, I see a lot of the techies have to move to the South, move to places where are completely without what you're used to. Okay, so the Bay Area is really a kicky outie of anybody who wants to be. You want to work as an Amazon seller or whatever. I don't think it's possible here in the Bay Area. I just don't think so. I don't think it's possible in any city that's hyped out in their property prices. So this is where we're at right now, is where do these sellers move? Where do because right now I've made the acquisition situation. I've put in the data. I have the inventory. I've made a shop. I don't even really want to get shop pushy with it, though, like with what I have or you know what could be sold, because I'm in a situation that's absolutely in a desperate stupidity of a no move, you know, and so because I'm stuck in this no move situation, I can't even really begin to even have the shop active, so. It's kind of crummy. This is all pretty crummy. Anyway, I'm being pushed into a destitution by others. I'm being pushed into a destitution because of the, yeah, it's okay for this my old father to live in this heinously costly Bay Area. Why is that okay for everyone? I want to know that. I want to know why it's okay for his friends to just go on year after year after year after year. Oh, that's okay for you to live this way. It's absolutely wrong. They're not friends. They're not friends at all. They call them on the phone, hey, let's go play golf. They're friends that have already been set up. You know, maybe they already have houses. Maybe they already have property. Maybe they're set up. Do you understand? He's not set up. And so when he's not set up and he can't afford, you know, the costs of those homes or whatever, who's going to be there all the time at the talkie-talkie? You know, where is she? Where is he? Where is she? Where is he? Who is going to be there? Because that's what it is with old people. They want to talk all the gosh dang time. So if you can't afford that rest home where they want to talk all the time, well, then it's going to be a daughter or it's going to be a son, isn't it? And so here I am in this heinously expensive situation. And no, I don't want to talk to any of his friends, former, current, or future even, because I'm tired of all of you. I just think you're absolutely reckless. You're reckless. You have not given advice. Now, a friend is supposed to give advice. Now, that's the wrong place. That's an obviously wrong place for you to live. Now, how do we get you out of there? That's a friend. How do we get you out of there? Instead, it's just like the negligence of ignore. Ignore the situation. Like maybe he'll just die tomorrow. How rude. How absolutely rude. So anyway, back to property. You know, just because he's old doesn't mean he's going to die tomorrow. Just because he's old. So anyway, so I'm in this situation. I'm like looking at South Carolina all happily for a moment. You know, I saw some houses for $40,000, you know. So I'm like, well, maybe there. And then I'm like, well, yeah, try to like switch his brain power into that direction is like an impossibility. You know, it's just like, what do you call it when people they have like this house stay nesting mentality and they just can't get out. And I'm just like, this is incredibly grievous to me, first of all, because I'm a traveler. I'm a world traveler. I've just traveled, you know. And I am just not used to this, what do we call it? It's to me, it's a prison. It's a prison to this stay put, have to, in this situation. It's a prison to not, you know, deal with yourself financially and correctly. It's a prison. I mean, it's okay to go ahead and move. It's okay to go ahead and move and live properly with what you have. But it's a prison as soon as you are living way above your means, you're living in a prison state. You know, you're living as a fool. And there's nothing I can do about it because there's something about that homeliness, it's not homeliness, that I have to stay in this situation. I have to stay here in the nest. Why are men nesting? What's all that about? Years and years and years of nesting. You know, rather than the absolute logic in the situation that says, well, wait a minute, your nest is too expensive. Help. Fix the situation. Okay, so I've been saying this for a year. I've said this before. And so what do I have? I have negligence coming in from my brothers that apparently don't care. They haven't changed the situation. They haven't amended the situation. They haven't pushed. They haven't been a friend. They have not been a friend. They have not given advice. Okay, so how to get out? Well, in the situation, I'm stuck. I'm stuck here. Absolutely stuck here. So now what do I do? Somebody is ruining my life over this situation. I mean, what's going on here? How is this okay? How is this fair? You know, I have properties lined up where you can have land, you can start a self community there with the food growing. Make one of those cooperative, whatever, gardens. You know, I have all these ideas. And instead, I'm ignored. Instead, I'm ignored. No, it's much better to run into destitution for my elderly father. It's much better. I mean, what planet are you living on? So who is doing this? Because you know full well and full-heartedly that I, without the tangible stay of what do we call it, the financial paperwork, the durancy situation, this is headed straight into severe destitution. Why? When it doesn't have to happen. Why? It's just appalling. It's just appalling, actually. Anyway. I know I'm not really helping, but my situation is just terrible. And so I'm like, well, okay. Seeing as how I just can't even leave. I can't even leave. Do you understand? Even if I could get buy a share property. And then I'm like, okay, well, where's the share properties now where you just buy with total strangers? You buy like, three of you buy a house in the South. Maybe that's the answer. You know, 10,000 here, 10,000 there, 10,000 somewhere else. And so there you have your house in the South purchased. Maybe that's the dang answer. But no, I'm not getting any kind of feedback, no help. I'm just getting some stupid, they just play their life away. Play their life away with no foresight. So I have no foresight going on. Just the hanging over pendulum of just wait. We can't wait until she's even more destitute. That's all they're pushing. That is all they are pushing on me on a daily basis. One more greedy little lunch out with my father. Is that who you are? Nasty brother. No answer. No answer to amend or fix the situation. Just negligence on your part. Okay, so yeah, so we have to set up these things called, and I don't even know, you know, what do I have to do, you know? This is just impossible. It's an impossible situation. They put, that's it. You know, the kids are just hoping for what, the driver machine into the rest home? Is that who you all are? You're just hoping for the driver machine into the rest home. Where are you going to drive him into what rest home? Not around here. And at that point, oh great. Is that your plan? Is that your plan? Elder brother? Is that your plan? Okay, so when I have family that's absolutely trying to hurt me, physically, emotionally, on a daily basis, by having me in the situation that is not repaired, the situation that is not fixed, the situation that is decadent. When I have family members that are not assisting. Running around saying, oh, we'll just move him to El Paso. What a bunch of garbage. What a bunch of garbage that is also. Can't even afford El Paso. How about that one? So yeah, so I'm being run into a desperate state for no reason. No reason whatsoever. Aside from their stupidity. Their stupidity in wanting what? My father to die in this house? Is that the imperative? I mean, how much child backflash hatred do you have on him? How much hatred do you have on your old father? I mean, I know I have my little childhood regression statements out there, but Jesus frickin' Christ, how much do you hate the man that you won't help him move to a better situation?